A lot's been said about Scott Brown after this game as well. Have you got any problem with anything he did in the match?
No, none whatsoever.
Has too much been made of it then, from your point of view?
I think so. It's gamesmanship and you have to deal with it. Even with that one there, I think that's been contested just so he can play tonight more than anything. I don't know what argument they can have with Ryan Kent there. You know, there's a bit of verbals, but the verbals happen all the time. So what, that warrants that kind of response? You know, I don't believe so. But yeah, Scott Brown's been a genius at it for years on end now. You know, he's been an antagonist for many a year, even when he was at Hibs. You know, and you see many other players more experienced trying to get in his psyche. So it's nothing new that we haven't seen before from Scott.
Steven Gerrard clearly not happy about that, about Scott Brown after the game.
Listen, there's lots of things Steven Gerrard wasn't happy about. And I'll tell you what emphasises that more. The timing of the winning goal. 10v10, his team had been up against it. The shape was good. I think the way he set up his tactics in the second half, they stayed in the game, they tried to be a threat in the counter-attack. There were so many positives for him in the game. And when it went 10v10, he probably thought, right, we've got a real chance of winning this. So I think the emotion has been brought more because of the timing of the goal from both sides. Celtic won in the league, almost euphoria from them, disappointment, frustration from Rangers. And for me, that's why it all boiled over. A professional game of two teams desperate to beat their rivals, and everything's been overcome because of the timing of the
goal. It was 10v9 because Celtic put Rogic on, who looked about 85 years old, didn't he? I mean, blimey,
he's
moving around like an OAP. Yeah, he was.
Can I ask you about Morelos? Because Rangers are becoming experts at playing with 10 men. They know how to do that. But Morelos off again.
Experts,
well, they've had to do it a few times this season.
Yeah,
would you play him again for Rangers? Because Steven Gerrard, obviously, after the game, was furious.
No, I wouldn't. I'd get rid of him. He can't be trusted. You know, we've even seen in the last couple of days, he made this statement apologising and then was speaking to Colombian radio and blaming everybody
today.
Else. But I mean, some of the things which have come out after the game have been slightly, you know, would have been slightly concerning. This stuff, you know, Steven Gerrard saying that Celtic are playing the victim card. This is a guy on the first day of the season who was complaining about conspiracy theories with referees. You know, if I came over and punched you and elbowed you in the face, Daryl, I would say you would be the victim in that situation. We saw massive deflection tactics.
That'd be people, very harsh for me to be fair that live on TV. You might not work again.
People talking about Scott Brown at the end of the game, who did very little. This is, you know, a Rangers team over the years. And I have no problem with this, by the way. I didn't agree with what Scott Brown did. It's not for me. Rangers teams over the years have celebrated with the huddle at Parkhead. Scott Arfield, you know, his celebration,
was
quite
it,
within his rights to do it at Ibrox.
Was it anything over-excessive?
Absolutely walked off. We saw Andy Halliday, a player who really, you know, was talking about, they were talking about Ibrox getting a DVD out about him because he made one tackle, which was 80-20 in his favour, and he's made a couple of throw-ins this season. And he's a bang average player who's trying to use these things and create mellies, which are there. Do your business on the pitch. You've had one win in the last three seasons. It's massive deflections worrying about Celtic. And let me tell you, Rangers haven't made progress this season. We'll hear everybody banging on about it. They've lost three times to Aberdeen. Kilmarnock have been better than them in the league. I think they've beaten them, Kilmarnock, and drawn twice. Rangers haven't beaten Hibs. So all this nonsense, Steven Gerrard has made progress. He's 13 points behind Celtic. They're out of the cup competitions. I've never heard so much waffle.
Are you done?
No!
It's his longest answer ever. By the way, listen, your two jobs tonight, listen, your last line of defence for me. But let me ask you about Morelos. Would you play him again?
Absolutely. He scored 29 goals, Darryl. You know, Chris is getting a bit excited. He contradicts himself. He wasn't happy.
We've got the Rangers cheerleader now.
No, he actually wants to...
give him a chance.
Big fella, I gave you the courtesy to do this. Let us retort, OK? So the actual reality was you contradicted yourself saying you weren't happy with him, then you go back to huddles and all that. Stick to the instance here.
Explain that. Explain the contradiction, because I don't
understand. Well, because you said that you didn't agree with him at the end, and then you went on to talk
about
huddles.
It's not for me, but you're missing the bigger point.
You're asking to give your opinion on it.
So you're deflecting now.
No, the actual reality is that he's actually let himself down by actually going over there and celebrating in front of him.
Where did the game finish? In the corner?
It doesn't matter. He doesn't have to do it in front of it. It's a Celtic captain we're talking about here.
Did it in front of them?
Bit of dignity. Walk away from the situation, celebrate with 59,000
fans. So we blame Scott Brown for everything, don't we? But it's okay when Rangers players do it and they're quite within their rights to do it when they've done it before.
There's a lot of madness going on at the moment. It doesn't have to rile people up.
Blame Scott Brown for everything. That's embarrassing. Deflection tactics.
I'm surprised you're sticking up for him.
I'm not sticking up for him.
Cheerleader for Celtic these days.
Wow.